Hello, welcome back, guys. It's me again, and welcome back to Joshua's Object Camp.
Stairs, back a stand! Another episode of that one playlist that isn't one of the four major series I have on the channel at the moment.
So, what exactly happened to the extremely random adventures of Yvonne? Joshua's Object Camp presents...
Concept Conception.
Hello everyone, welcome back to an episode of Concept Conception. I know it's been a while, but yeah. It's back now. Although at this point, one of the other reasons is that I actually had a ton of ideas for it, finally, after all this time. And as well, I kinda don't want, like, the world tour to overtake this series and number of videos too much. Like, the world tour was originally intended to be filler. This was intended to be a more, permanent thing. But, it looks like the world tour is far more prominent these days in this series, so let's see if we can fix that. At any rate, today I'm not going to talk to you about what's happened to the adventures of Yvonne, although there is a 16th episode that is a work in progress.
Mash it. No.
Anyways, that is not what I am here to talk to you about today. What I'm here to talk to you about today is a bunch of old concept art for bounty hunters that really were not planned on appearing in the series whatsoever. They are still drawings, though, that were produced back in the day and that were relevant to the series at one point or another. So I figured, why not put them on full display? You know what I mean? I mean, the drawings will probably look horrible compared to what other people are capable of doing, and I'm gonna feel, incredibly insignificant when, people inevitably tell me that these drawings are terrible and they can probably hire a better artist for merely $5. But yeah, at any rate, let's get started with the first one. I figured we'd start with the oldest drawing and work our way towards the newest one. But first, little bit of background quickly. Most of these drawings, and actually, let me just quickly check. I have them right next to me here, just in case there's an outlier. There is not. Okay, all of these are formatted in the same way. The guild symbol is in the upper left and the bottom right-hand corners. For all of these, this time around, there will be, lips symbols there, like lip sync. Like, that's the guild Yvonne belongs to, in case you didn't notice. But, yeah. In the other two corners, the top right and bottom left-hand corners, there is a rank, or a letter, inside of the little circle there. This denotes the rank of the hunter. For the purposes of this video, they will either be A, B, C, D, E, or F. There are two other ranks, but we're not really gonna go over them in this conception, because they're a bit more of a special case, and I think if I'm gonna cover them, they kinda deserve their own episode. So, at any rate, let's kick things off with
you!
Another letter, but, completely different. It's not a rank. That's all you need to know. Right, so taking a look at this drawing right next to me here, right off the bat, it's giving me off some, it's giving off some Final Fantasy X related vibes here. I guess that's kind of the inspiration I took with this. Like, we have Final Fantasy X's, like, Dreams Xanarkand, maybe the final battle specifically, in the, on the left here, and then we have the Ruins of Xanarkand on the right. I'm not saying this is intended to be Xanarkand, but it's definitely where I got the inspiration from, if you know the game. Now here is what is interesting. We have a little bit of a Matryoka thing going on here, and I apologize if I pronounced that incorrectly, but if I did, what you need to know is that I was referring to the Russian nesting doll. We have like a statue on the outermost layer, then we have like a letter U with some sort of symbol on it, and then we have the actual person controlling everything. Behind the little tractor beam of sorts, we have what seems to be a clone of Yvonne. There is no bio on the back of this one. There are bios on the back of some of the others, but for this one, here's what I can gather based on the image alone. This guy, he intends on duplicating other bounty hunters to do the work for him, in a sense. So these bounty hunters go out, they do the deed, they come back, and he takes the credit for doing the things that they did. It's a little weird, but technically he's duplicating them and controlling it of his own will, so... I mean, technically it isn't against the rules of the guild, but, I mean, I'd be kind of careful if I was him, because, Not exactly the best practice, and maybe the ministers of the guild realized this, because, he's an F rank, as you can clearly see. Assuming this thing scanned properly, I hope it did, but, yeah. So, I just got done editing the first part of the vid. It's kind of long. Hopefully this part will be shorter. On to the second drawing, we have... ketchup. Which is really just like a ketchup bottle. Funny story about this, in real life, I was actually inspired to make this drawing, not like the last one, like where inspiration was clearly from a video game, as you can see in the last edited segment. This one was actually based off of a real container that I saw, and I'm like, I need to draw this. So I figured, why not do it? But then I like added a couple, you know, fantastical elements, obviously. This bottle has a face, this bottle has, like... And if you look closely, this bottle has, like, a little cuff. But that cuff does not belong to the bottle. The cuff belongs to... And this is where we get into the backstory of this individual, or should we say the backstory of the individual controlling him? The mysterious condiment killer. Legend has it, you see, that nobody has ever quite seen his face, you see? He sneaks up on his victims, each with a different condiment bottle in hand, as his sort of ventriloquist puppet. Goes in there and does the job. He makes the condiments, the puppets, turn in and collect the money. But it's really him that's getting the majority of the credit. It's not just ketchup, either. Relish, mustard, which was never drawn. Plum sauce, which actually was drawn. Sorry, Zach, if you happen to be watching this video, I never got to drawing mustard. I got to drawing relish before mustard, but it was never finished. At any rate, he's such a mystery that the guild doesn't even know what he looks like. So whenever they had to do a portrayal of him for these cards that were being manufactured, as propaganda for the guild. They didn't know exactly what he looked like, so they had to go with a fairly prominent artist rendering instead. Funnily enough, ironically enough as well, my artist rendering of this individual was never completed. So, yeah. At any rate, not much else to say about this individual. And again, there's nothing on the back of this one. So yeah, very quick. Very short segment. Also, really bad pun there. I know at least someone on a certain server that's going to get a kick out of that, maybe. I don't know. But yeah, let's move on. I think we got time for about one more at least. Alrighty then, what do we have next? Oh boy. Artist to other artists here. Do you ever take a look back at some of your older work and you're just like, wow, why did I do this again exactly? That is essentially this drawing in a nutshell. Except the interesting part is, I actually know why I did this. A little bit of the man behind the channel here. I personally think one of the worst things a person can lose as they age is their sense of wonder and excitement. Imagination, if you will. I feel as though all your creative problem-solving skills and stuff like that, like your creativity, creative solutions for problems, you know, stuff like that, you know? It stems, like, from there. At least, that's my philosophy. Views on this might differ. But I thought as though when I was around this time, when I drew this, like, that I was losing my sense of imagination. Plus, without going too deep into this concept here, I mean, at the end of the day, this is supposed to be, at the end of the day, in the same multiverse as, like, Jock and Kodak and all that jazz. So I'm like, there's far too many humans inside of here. So I'm like, okay, how can we rectify this? And thus, we come to Mount Trifecolia. I hope I pronounced that right. Then again, it's my character, so I don't know, maybe somebody's drawn a traffic cone volcano before. I don't know. But yeah, it's very clearly a traffic cone. It's got teeth. It's basically a giant volcano. That little circle there, toward the bottom right-hand corner, that is a, that's like a mine entrance of sorts. And obviously it's got a little bit of lava spewing from the top. Obviously I would have colored this all in these days, instead of, just leaving it the way it is. Because I just would have been like, well, it looks a little bland, don't you think? And I mean, sure, the color up top does help the rest of it to stand out, but to what extent? Also, no idea why I decided to classify this hunter as a D rank instead of like an F rank, or actually, apparently I must have known at one point why I decided to class this hunter as a D rank, because there is something on the back of this one.
The biography of Mount Trifecolia. Its real identifier is mining site number 1801. Its bounty hunting alias is Mount Trifecolia. It was once little more than a mine shaft in a barren hillside. But word soon got out once it was revealed that it was the number one oil mine on the planet Minoria. However, it soon became obvious that everyone that wanted the oil would get to it under any means necessary. So, the weaponized Mount Trifecolia was created in order to protect the mine. It would soon be known by the miners as home base, a place where they could chill out while on break, store their daily findings, and act out commands to extract the oil. Unfortunately, some idiot let the oil become the fuel for the weaponized mountain, and eventually it drove them out after a series of deaths within the mine itself, before those varying oil eruptions. Today, those who tread in Mount Trifecolia's pastures will soon be embedded into the bedrock. Lip Sync Senior, head of the guild.
I know what you're thinking. Yes, if this planet is real, the United States would definitely like to invade it. For those of you that didn't think that, well, why? Why? Why didn't you think that? No, but in all seriousness, this is quite the weird hunter. I have no idea why I made this at the end of the day, but, At any rate, it also occurs to me that at this point, we're only 3 drawings in, and I've rambled for well over 10 minutes. And I'm just like, wow. First off, if you actually managed to listen to me for this long, instead of the majority of you leaving at, like, the minute mark, or even earlier, maybe later, hopefully, I don't know. But yeah, to those of you who were willing to listen to me ramble this long,
Good for you!
Unfortunately, we still have 4 drawings to go, so... Or 3, I don't know. We'll see. At any rate, I guess I will see you back here in a potential Concept Conception Episode 6, where I talk about the remaining drawings I could not get to today. And hopefully I actually remember to record that episode this time instead of waiting several years to upload the next episode of the series. Hopefully. Maybe.